Are you Warren Jeffs?
Yes.
All right, Mr. Jeffs, you're being held as a fugitive, and there are two fugitive holds for you, one from Utah, one from Arizona. I'm going to explain to you very quickly what your rights are in regards to being a fugitive from justice. Then you tell me what you want to do. You have the right to demand that a formal warrant of extradition be issued and served upon you. That is called a governor's warrant. You have the right to apply for a review of the legality of your arrest and confinement that is referred in legal terminology to a writ of habeas corpus. You probably have to have an attorney do that for you, and you would have to hire that attorney because you don't get court-appointed counsel on a fugitive case. The process of obtaining a governor's warrant takes approximately 90 days plus whatever extra time you're in custody. You're going to be held without bail during this fugitive process. Okay, you can shorten that 90-day plus time by waiving extradition rights, the rights that I just explained to you. If you waive those rights, the state of Arizona and Utah would have a maximum of 30 days to come get you. I don't think it's going to take them that long. Also, I think between the states of Arizona and Utah, they have worked out an arrangement so that if you waive extradition, you're going to be going to Utah first. So you should be aware of that. Now, do you understand everything I just explained?
Yes.
Okay, what would you like to do?
Go ahead and be extradited.
You want to waive your rights in regards to extradition and go back as quickly as they can have the, they can come pick you up?
Yeah.
All right. I need to have some paperwork here. Actually, it looks like you've already signed both waivers. Is that correct? All right, I'm going to sign the order indicating that extradition rights have been waived. In addition, I need to also inform you that the District Attorney's Office is here today from St. George, Utah, and they have some information that the bail is going to serve you. This is not the governor's warrant. This is just some local charges in St. George that's pending. You need to be apprised. There's the warrant, and it's also a no bail. That's a request for a hearing on a no bail warrant in St. George. So as soon as you get extradited to Utah, they'll set the hearing date, and we'll put on the record that you've been served with that warrant. All right? All right. That will conclude these proceedings. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Your Honor.
All right, we're going to go back and finish.